Good morning students, I am Pavan, your science master. Today I would like to speak to 7th class students. Students, in the previous class I introduced a new concept, that is acids and bases, right? So in this lesson we talked about some of the materials can be classified based on their nature, based on their taste, state, shape, etc., right? In the last class we talked about some of the tastes of the food items, you know, some of the tastes like sweet, sour, bitter, salty, spicy, etc. And I asked you to make the table ready to discuss what is the reason for the taste of that materials, food materials. Okay, students, actually the main reason for the taste of the food substances is either acid or base or none of these. Okay, now actually some of the names of the things are given here. Tomato sauce. Tomato sauce is sour in taste, right? Tomato sauce. Orange, okay, orange is also little sour in taste. Lemons also sour in taste. And you don't taste vinegar, I think, but it will be also sour in taste. Next, what might be the reason, what might be the reason for sour taste of these things? There are some substances present in them. They are different in different things, like, you know, tomato sauce. In tomato it consists of an acid, oxalic acid. And in oranges, orange and lemon, in both of these there is an acid called citric acid. And vinegar, vinegar is acetic acid. Names of the substances present in these things, they are the factors for the taste that we feel like this, you know. And in the first lesson we talked about food substances, names of food substances like carbohydrates, proteins, right? Same like that here, these things contain some other substances and they are the reason for the taste, like like sour. Okay, so, tomatoes consists of oxalic acid, orange and lemon consists of citric acid, and vinegar consists of what? Acetic acid. And next, surf water or liquid soap. Surf water, it consists of surf water, toilet soap, and toothpaste. And these are the tastes of these things are little bitter, right? Okay, yeah, what might be the reason for the taste of these things? Yeah, they are, surf water consists of potassium hydroxide, and toilet soap consists of sodium hydroxide. And then what is left? Sugar, salt and chalk pieces. See children, chalk pieces. Chalk piece neither acid nor base. It's this kind of substances are called neutral substances. Okay, these kind of substances, these kind of materials or substances are called neutral substances. Neutral substances. And salt is also neutral substance. Okay, NEU, neutral substance. Yeah, now let us classify these things based on the nature, like taste. You know, sour in tastes and bitter in taste, and salt, we can say salt is salty in taste, sugar sweet in taste. But we say that sugar is neither acid nor base. Okay children, we will discuss in detail about that in the later on classes. What are the things that we discussed here? Tomato sauce consists of oxalic acid, and oranges and lemon consists of citric acid, and vinegar consists of acetic acid. Next, surf water or soap water, surf water or toilet soap consists of, you know, bases like potassium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide and sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide. And oranges over. Next, and toothpaste is also made up of a base that we will discuss in the later on classes. Next, so based on the tastes of the materials, we can classify them like this, and the nature, the taste of these materials is based on the substances, a specific substance present in that. They are like this, is oxalic acid, potassium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, citric acid and acetic acid, etc. Okay children, so these are the substances mainly reason for the taste or the nature of these materials that we have discussed so far. And here children, this is just example I'm giving you, and there is an activity that I want you to understand to identify the nature of these substances, whether it is an acid or a base or none of these two. So how can we identify? Is there anything that helps us to identify them, like it's like that's an acid or base or none of these? None of these in the sense, and when the thing that is neither acid nor base, that comes under another group called neutral. Okay, that is neutral group, they are nothing but salts. Okay, what are they? If the substance is neither acidic nor basic, then that can be called as what? Neutral substance. Okay, in general the substances, the neutral substances are called salts. Okay, here I want you to understand mainly how can we identify whether the substance, whether the thing is acidic or basic. How can you identify? Children, how can you identify? So, as we have done some of the experiments to identify some of the presence of substances in different food items, right? Same like that, here also we have to do some experiments to find the thing is acidic or basic or neutral like this. Okay, see, to identify here, there is a simple experiment that you can understand. What you have to do is, take some turmeric powder and make it paste by adding water, and take one paper and apply this turmeric paste on the paper and let it dry, and take some surf and add some water to that and make it surf water, and you make some designs on the turmeric, dried turmeric paper using the soap water on it. And you observe that actually what will be the color of the turmeric paper. That's right, yellow, right? And when you add soap or surf water to eat, what? Turmeric. This turmeric yellow turns into red. After you add soap or surf water to this turmeric yellow paper, that turns red. Okay. See, this is turmeric indicates the nature of soap or surf by changing its color. By changing whose color? It means turmeric color. See children, turmeric indicates what? Turmeric indicates the nature of soap or surf by changing its color. Okay, so can you say this turmeric as an indicator? Turmeric indicates the nature, so we can say turmeric is an indicator. Turmeric is an indicator. Turmeric is what? An indicator that you can identify the nature of, or that you can note, you can find the nature of soap or surf. You know, what might be the nature of soap or surf? In the previous points that we discussed, the soap, surf or soap consists of base in it, right? Base in it. Okay, so turmeric indicates the nature of soap or surf by changing its color. So what might be the soap and surf here? Soap or surf here? Base. So here turmeric is an indicator. It's a It's an indicator. So you can note the definition of indicator here. Indicator, you can note the definition of indicator. Indicator means it's a substance which helps us to identify the nature of other substance. Okay, indicator means a substance which indicates or shows the change in it, a substance which indicates or shows a change in it to identify the nature of other substances, the nature, like, you know, whether it is acid or base or neutral. Okay, so there are different indicators, like, you know, there are some natural indicators, there are some and there are some artificial indicators. Okay, and we will discuss in detail about all of these things. What are natural indicators, what are artificial indicators, that means man-made indicators, and that all we will discuss in the next class. And I want you to write what is indicator and write this in your notebook and present it in our WhatsApp group. Okay, children, this is for today. Thank you for listening. Thank you, one and all.